What's up, guys? Welcome to the Luke Mind Power podcast. I hope you're doing amazing. This is a small segment that I'm going to start introducing now, and it's called Success Stories. And it's working with our extraordinary clients of mine that have taken action, have been working through our group coaching programs or working with me privately. And one thing that I know myself is that when we hear stories of people overcoming their challenges or taking action to, you know, invest in themselves or learn how to overcome their struggles of their past or their trauma or insecurities and all that kind of stuff, it inspires us. You know, I know myself that I actually am here because of seeing other people overcome their challenges and hearing other people's stories and what they were going through in life and then them overcoming it. And that then inspired me to let me know that, wow, if it's possible for them, it's possible for me. And so the purpose of this segment called Success Stories is to basically share people's stories of success in taking action, working with myself and my transformational coaches every single week so that they can live their dreams, not their fears. So, you know, without further ado, I want to introduce to you someone extraordinary who has been a part of our community for quite some time in the Superpower Mastermind 20-week group coaching program. Her name is Gudrun, and she is from Iceland. Welcome, Gudrun, to the Luke Mind Power podcast.
Thank you so much, Luke. So happy to be here with you.
Absolutely, absolutely. I'm happy to have you on the Luke Mind Power podcast all over, you know, YouTube and Spotify and Apple and all the other podcast platforms. But let's start with you kind of introducing yourself as, like, you know, who are you and what do you do?
So, okay, yeah, like you said, my name is Gudrun and I am a teacher by a profession. I'm 52 years old. I have a son. And I love my job, but what I discovered last year, or I knew about myself, I knew there was something else, you know, something more. And I asked the universe for a sign, and it really delivered, because at that time I listened. And that is something that I've learned this past year, because in the end of January, specifically on the 28th of January, I connected with you. I saw you dancing in the bushes, and I was like, I had asked the universe, just, I am here. I was like just empty. And, you know, I just knew, just in my heart, there was something more. And I was just so ready. And I came across you on social media. And how you approached, you know, your audience really resonated with me. And we started chatting, and it blew me away. And I tell you, like we have talked before, I didn't believe in a way. I just wanted to do something. And there's something you talked to my heart, and I was like, I'm going to take this leap. And I haven't regretted it for a minute since.
It's amazing.
Yeah.
So just with that being said, everybody who's tuning in, guys, you know, just all I could think about while Gudrun was sharing was, you know, this is real people and real stories, you know. And I know that I, in my podcast, when I'm communicating and I'm talking and I'm sharing my wisdom, you know, it's me, it's Luke Mindpower. But, you know, to listen to you, Gudrun, and for people to be tuning in right now, they're like, wow, this is a real person that has a real story, that has a real challenge, that has a real life, you know. And this is where we get to inspire people, because we allow ourselves to be vulnerable, you know, and to be able to speak our truth and share our story. So it's phenomenal. But let us know, why did you actually join the Superpower Mastermind? What was it that you felt you really needed to build or overcome?
Because this communication, I got to speak to you one-on-one. That was like, because I had been watching you for a little while, and this approach was really personal, and we got to chat for, you know, we chatted for 2 times, I think it was. And, you know, this is an investment, and there's something, I just listen to myself. I'm just like this ordinary, I'm just like plain person, which I love and so proud of. And at the time, I was just seeking, you know, me. And there's something, when we were talking, you had a belief in me that I didn't. And I believed, I didn't believe you, me, but I believed you, you know, in a way. You were like, I'm going to tell you, this is going to be, you know, you're going to, you know, all the changes and the transform. And I was like, yeah, yeah. But there was something in you that opened my heart for the opportunity that it might happen. So there is something, some energy, there is something, I don't know what it is, but I, yeah. And I just was so ready to take the leap. So I've invested, this is an investment in yourself. And this is the best investment that I have made in myself. You know, we all have stories, and I have, you know, and the amount of transformation and the healing that has, you know, done for me this past year is phenomenal. And I know it, you know.
I remember one time you were sharing in the community and you were talking, actually, I think it was one of our live events that we had towards the end of last year, and you were actually sharing with everybody. And you said that when you were on the call with me, you know, just before you were signing up and you were taking action, I said to you that within the first week, your whole life is going to change.
Yeah. I remember, and I was like, yeah, right. But I mean, yeah, but there was something that, I mean, this opportunity and you being that sure, because this is true. I could tell that to somebody else, you know. Today I can say, just wait, you know, you're going to change for the first 2 weeks or, and it really happens. It happens, you know, we go two steps, you know, it's the cha-cha-cha always, we go, you know, two steps forward and then one step back. But all the time I was on the way up, and I felt, and you know, when you don't trust yourself or you just don't trust, and you come into a community of such beauty and like where you're so safe. I've never belonged to a community that is so safe. That is just true. And because you have, you guys, the team and the people who are in it, we make it that way, you know. We are not there to judge. And I had such a judgmental mind just upon myself. And so now I can recognize it. It's not, everything is not gone. I am still the same person. But I noticed the narrative. I know it's there and I can pour into myself, you know. And yeah, this is definitely what you said was true. And I know it today.
Yeah. Awesome. So tell us, what did you actually achieve or heal?
Wow. First of all, it is the inner child work, I would say. The trust, of course, in the community, first of all. The module work, when you start, you don't know what you're doing. And I did it just in steps. I almost never looked at, we have the 6 module in the 20-week super mastermind. And I usually just took, because I was like fragile. I didn't want to be overwhelmed. And I think that is the best way. And I think, and then when I traveled inside and I learned that I always thought like when I was young, that was like in the back and the future was in the front. Now, I mean, I am the same girl as I was small. So I can say and embrace myself and say, I love you, because then I'm pouring love into the little girl inside of me who went through all kinds of hardship and was really sensitive and needed support, needed being seen. And I think that is so, it changes you so much and it heals so much inside. And then you take all the responsibility. I do not judge, never, not my parents or anything. I know where they are, you know, they come from a different space and place and they had their sorrows. But I am responsible about me. I can reparent me. I can say, Gudrun, you know, I can see myself as 5. But just here and now, I don't have to like, it was so interesting how the mind, and I noticed this just in this work, how the mind, my mind works. Nothing is, the eternal now is just now, this moment, you know. And that is transformational. And I would say the team and the community and this inner child work, and this pouring into, you know, the mirror work, definitely.
So self-love is a big key and a big part of the program. But I remember that you actually have, you said this, and now I say it. So you actually came up with a powerful statement. And I remember when you said this, you said that when you start feeling guilty for doing what's right for you, that means you're growing.
Yeah.
And when I heard you say that, I was like, thank you.
Yeah.
Because basically now, and I say this to my private clients that I'm working with as well, and everybody else in the Superpower Mastermind that is in the, you know, the program as well, because it is true, you know, in order for you to break out of like what you've been just habitually used to doing, you start putting yourself first. You start doing different things that it's not the same as who you were, right? Because you have to, in order for this new version for you to emerge, you've got to start living a different way. And you feel guilty for not being available for people or for doing what's right for you. And that's one of the hardest things, because you almost feel like you're obligated or obliged to continue to be selfless and to put other people first and to say yes to things that normally, or now when you're starting to grow, you have to say no. You have to say yes to yourself. How has that been now for you as you've grown so much? Are you still finding it that you're going through experiences where you're feeling guilty?
Yeah. Yeah. I think, and that is the best revelation of all. It's not going anywhere and it's okay. Because I know when I feel, and it's like, I'm so much more kind. I show myself grace. When I feel those feelings, I say it's okay. If you're feeling bad, you have this guilt, or you are doing something and you are like stressed, then yes, that is just fantastic. That is my, you know, if I'm always really comfortable, I'm always like really, really in my little comfort zone. So, and I think I remember, because when I said this, there was somebody who was going out of their comfort zone, doing something that they're not used to, and they felt guilty about it. And then I'm like, yeah, that's the best. And, you know, and that is definitely growth when you are doing something new, when you're going mm-hmm. out of your comfort zone mm-hmm. and you are standing up for you. And that is one thing what I've noticed is that I didn't, and that is what I call the magic of life. You do something for yourself. You stand up, you say no, you stop the people pleasing or whatever it is. There's a line in the sand. All of a sudden, you feel more self-love. You know, of course, you are doing all kinds of things, but you do something, you say no, and you feel your self-worth. You feel your self-worth growing. So it is just, it is phenomenal. This, to recognize this is really great. And also when you, I've noticed just recently, I have this epiphany this year, is that I know my self-worth is growing. I feel it. I can watch myself and love myself. And then all of a sudden, there are all kinds of things that I want to work on. I'm like, I don't want to feed my body this because I have more self-worth. And that is a ripple effect. You know, it changes. Like, oh, I want to move my body because I respect me. So it has a huge ripple effect, which we don't see. I'm like looking in the mirror and I'm pouring self-love and I'm thinking self-love with growth, but also self-worth, your value of yourself. So this is like, and that is the magic and the most beauty in it, in my opinion.
So Gudrun, there's a lot of people out there in the world that are probably listening to this and watching this. Take us to how you were before, because mm-hmm. if someone's interested in the Superpower Mastermind or working with us mm-hmm. and joining this amazing experience of transformation and growth and becoming that better version of yourself, what are some of the things that like you were dealing with so that people can really like go, wow, that's what I have? You know, what is it? Self-doubt, insecurities, what were they like for you?
Yeah, definitely not like speaking up. I have a lot to say and a lot to give. And I was like always quieting. I mean, I almost whispered when I started, and I have all kinds, you know, when I have trust in people like my best friend, I speak my truth, you know, because we have a trust. to the world, I was a bit quiet, you know. And then I know I have, so it's like dimming me, not believing in myself, really not, you know, self-worth was like, I didn't like look up to myself. I was like, I was just, you know, I wasn't thriving at all. And I remember I had those like dark clouds just inside me. And I think I knew there was more because it is more. It is all inside of me and everything is there. I just didn't know. And being really shy with a lot of, you know, things to give, you know. So stepping out, you know, you have to like take a leap. You have to like, and that is the biggest step you take in the beginning, isn't it? To take the leap and say, I'm going to do this for me. So I'm just this like, yeah. And I always felt this feeling. I know I can feel more whole. I was like empty inside. And like, yeah, I just did not love me. I did not. And I watched myself like before in the mirror. I was like, I didn't like what I saw, you know. And I knew that I had work to do. And I think many people can resonate in all kinds of ways. And just like, and I was waiting. Now I'm just in this day. This is just, it's a blessing to be alive today, isn't it? And that gives you this comfort of like, and also all the small things too. I mean, I get to wake up, move my body, you know, feed myself, go to work. I think this is, and that is the biggest change of all, is to like be really grateful, even though you can do a lot of big things too. But this is life, isn't it?
That's so amazing. So yeah. You said that you didn't love yourself. And so how are you feeling right now?
Well, the thing what changed the most for me is that there are, because our society, and we have this condition of, you know, of thoughts that we should be this and should be that. It is all there, you know, but I can, what, you know, look past it, you know, and see like your body is such a miracle. You see all those trillions of cells working and fighting, trying to find balance in every moment of your life. That is just, and you, I can watch myself and love this, love it. Just, and also things that I don't like I've always, you know, said many times, I can love that part, even though I can like improve in some ways, but that's like, I'm so much more than you see. And that is something that I was many years, I was always thinking about my appearance, not my soul, you know. And then when you like go on this travel inside yourself, you find you, the soul behind the thoughts. You can like recognize the thoughts, you know, and you are the soul behind it. And this was like, this is the spiritual part of me that has grown a lot. And I also, it's okay to have a bad day. It's okay to be not okay. And if you give yourself that, it's okay not to be okay. You have more grace and you have more kindness to you. And when you're kind and you love yourself, you love everyone else, you know. That is.
That's what Dr. Sebi has a video where he says, when you love yourself, you love the whole world. I love that. It's so good.
Because we are the world, isn't it? We are all.
Yeah. It's so good. So Gudrun, what is your dream? Like, what are you working towards? Do you have a goal or something that you would like to achieve moving forward?
Well, definitely. I have all kinds of dreams and goals. And what I've come to learn is that I know I can make my dreams come true if I am, you know, if I feel like, if I want to be abundant, I know the feeling of abundance. I was thinking about it. So I remember when I get a new job and I get something, I can feel this feeling in my heart. I can just make it. Like, highest goal is to change the world from my heart. So just like connecting with people or like just being the change, small change make the ladder, isn't it? I would like to move forward with my self-love journey. I would like to share so much more, like on any platform. I'm just like, I have been doing some shorts on YouTube, my YouTube channel, but I'm not ready to. I'm just feeling it. I'm just listening to my intuition. So, and change, and I can feel it. I am changing the world around me, you know. And I would like to work, like keep going and working in our community, you know, be like, be the light that you want to see in the world. That is definitely my end goal. And I can do, and I'm like open to like all kinds of possibilities because I believe in the world, you know, I believe in the delivery. And I am so ready to just step out of my comfort zone. So I am open to new, all kinds of opportunities. And that is, and there's more like a feeling than it's like, I want to have this house or this. And that has changed in this year since I started this. I wanted this summer house with my dog. And that is going to be, will happen. But I have like this more like a feeling. And also this content in the day. And find this abundant feeling, and everything, you attract what your heart wants, or not like want, what you are, you know. So it's like, yeah, just grow and keep up this work, you know, what I'm doing, connect with people, you know, help to change the world. That is what we need in this world, is we need love and love in each other, more kindness. And that is what I see is growing.
But Gudrun, thank you so much for jumping on. Thank you so much for sharing your story. It's amazing. You know, you're still with us in the Superpower Mastermind. It's a blessing to have you part of the amazing community that we're building and growing all the time, and surrounding yourself with amazing people that are taking action, investing in themselves. Where can people connect with you if they want to follow you or find you on social media?
Yeah, they can connect me on Instagram and Facebook, for example. Mm-hmm.
So, ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for joining Success Stories on the Luke Mind Power podcast. If you feel called and you feel like you're ready for action, you're ready to surround yourself with a positive community, and you want to go through my proven system, a blueprint that's going to help you to live your dreams, not your fears, and help you to learn to love yourself and transform your whole life and build superpowered confidence and overcome your trauma and your pain and your past, then all you need to do is click on the link in the description below, or if you're tuning in on one of our podcast platforms, you can simply go to my Instagram page, Luke Mind Power, and send me a direct message and write the word power, and I will get in touch with you to see if and how we could possibly help you transform your life. Thank you so much, guys, and I will see you on the next episode. Thank you for joining me on this journey of self-discovery and growth. If you're ready to grow and reach your full potential and find inner peace, send me a DM that says, I want inner peace, and I'll send you the next steps. You can accomplish anything you set your mind to. When you change your mind, you change your whole life. So don't hesitate and send that DM over to me. Myself and my team can't wait to meet you and witness your transformation in full glory. See you next week.